Hello guys, in this video we are going to carry out this particular transformation. So in the first step, this phenol derivative is subjected to the reaction with chloroform in presence of potassium hydroxide, and in the second step it is reacted with hydrogen peroxide in presence of sodium hydroxide. So let us consider step by step. So initially the first step will be the Riemann-Thiemann reaction, as you know, but I am doing the mechanism of Riemann-Thiemann reaction once again. So in presence of strong base like potassium hydroxide, an alpha elimination will happen into the chloroform moiety, and thereby dichlorocarbene will be generated into the reaction medium, which is of singlet character. And why singlet character? Because the electron pair remains inside this sp2 hybrid orbital, and this p orbital is vacant, and due to this vacant p orbital, this dichlorocarbene behaves as a singlet carbene, and due to that reason it possesses electrophilic character. And that's why when this dichlorocarbene is generated in the reaction medium, this phenol will attack this dichlorocarbene intermediate. So since this para position is already blocked by this ethyl group, so either of these two ortho positions will be attacked by the dichlorocarbene. So here and after this, this particular intermediate will form this C negative center, will immediately abstract this proton, and this moiety will be re-aromatized again. So the next intermediate will be this one, and after that the OH minus of potassium hydroxide will attack this CHCl2 group, and during the attack, one Cl minus will leave from the system, and thereby generating this particular intermediate. And then in the next step, this O minus will essentially abstract this hydrogen atom, and this oxygen carbon double bond will be formed, and this Cl will be eliminated from this system as Cl minus. And thereby our final product of the first step will be this aldehyde compound. So this is basically the Riemann-Thiemann reaction, and after that we have to consider the reaction of this particular compound with hydrogen peroxide in presence of sodium hydroxide. So what will happen? Sodium hydroxide will abstract one proton from the hydrogen peroxide, and thereby a better nucleophile will be generated in the reaction medium, which is the hydroperoxide anion. This will then attack this carbonyl center, which will form this particular species. And it then will undergo a intramolecular rearrangement, where this O minus will form a carbon oxygen double bond, and this total aromatic group will migrate to this oxygen center, and OH minus will leave from the system. And this reaction is known as Dakin reaction. So after this rearrangement, the compound will be this one. right, which will be then hydrolyzed by this sodium hydroxide present in the reaction medium. This O minus will attack this carbonyl center, thereby breaking this carbon oxygen bond, which will generate the final product. And after a aqueous workup, it will be converted into this compound. So this is our final product after the two steps. The first step is the Reimer-Tiemann reaction and the second step is the Dakin reaction. So this is it. Thank you for watching this video. See you in the next video.